Sage, your porch is so nice.
Thanks. We play cards out here at night and watch the sunset. We had to add on to it after Bill had his stroke so there'd be enough room for his wheelchair. What, honey?
I just don't know how you do it.
Do what?
All of it. I just don't know what to do for Derek. He's been so different since he came back from the war. I don't know what to say to him. It is more than just him having trouble with his hand. He's so forgetful. He can't even remember how to make a sandwich. He needs help with everything. I don't know what to do for him.
Oh, Katie.
I'm sorry for crying.
No, don't be. It was very hard for me. I remember feeling very numb at first.
Yeah, I don't know what I feel like anymore. I'm just sad, I guess.
I think one of the most important things I have learned from these last 5 years is that with caregiving, and that's what we are, caregivers, is that it all starts with us.
What do you mean?
I mean, if you don't take care of yourself first, then you can't help Derek. If you don't look out for yourself, then you can't help Derek. What I mean is, I bet you're tired, more tired than you can ever remember being.
Yes, so tired all the time.
Do you fret?
Yes. I have started to worry about things that I never worried about before.
It feels like if you tried to lie down for a nap, then the house might just burn down?
Yes.
Oh, honey, I went through all of that too. Sleepless nights, days I couldn't eat, days I ate too much, and at times I would just cry for no reason.
Does it ever get better?
Why, yes, it does. But you have to start with you.
How do I do that?
Well, first you have to take care of yourself. Have you been to a doctor lately?
No, I haven't been sick.
It's a good idea to get a checkup because stress can affect you. If you get sick and are in bed for a week, then who's going to help Derek? You know what really helped me is when I started eating better and cut down on the caffeine.
Yeah, I've been eating a lot of takeout.
Fruits and vegetables will make you feel a lot better. Sleep helped me the most. When I started getting 7 or 8 hours again, I felt much better.
I'm sure that would help, but some nights I have so much on my mind, I just can't settle down.
Have you thought about seeing a counselor?
Well, I don't think I'm to that stage yet.
You know, it's something to think about. I didn't want to see a therapist at first because I was afraid that it meant something was wrong. Finally, I realized that something was wrong. My therapist really helped me. There are other ways you can get help, too. Have you looked into support groups? There are many support groups for wives and wounded soldiers. And that could give you a lot of help and encouragement. And how about the power of the ask?
The ask?
Yes, you know people want to help, but often they don't know what to say, even much less what to do.
Really?
Yes, I call it the power of the ask. I have the power to ask for what I need, and they have the power to help me, which is something they really want to do anyway. For example, maybe you could ask for someone to take Derek out 2 or 3 hours on Saturday morning so you could do something you enjoy. What kind of things do you like to do?
Before Derek got hurt, I was training for a 10K.
Wow! If you take a little time for yourself, you'll be much better able to help Derek. I know the Park and Recreation Department has a great gym.
I don't know if I would have time for that. I barely have time to go get groceries.
Well, I have a nursing assistant come into the house to help out.
A nursing assistant?
Yes. I had her come much more in the beginning when Bill needed 24-hour care. That gave me time to run errands. There's also respite care, where someone comes to the house for a day or a weekend, and you can go out of town to see friends or your family. I did that twice in the beginning, and it really helped me.
Thank you so much, Sage. You have really given me some good ideas.
I am glad.